Teacup Tempest by Wigwam. Anko stared. Ito stared back. Anko leaned in a little, raising an eyebrow. Ito blinked innocently.
Fine! You win! Anko threw up her arms and slumped back in her seat, pushing the last bowl of dango over to the kid. If there was one thing she liked about babysitting, it was that she could fill the kid up with candy and sugar and send him home. Kai watched them in loud amusement. I see that Tatsumaki-san has allowed you to watch over her son for her. The man bounced on the balls of his feet and Hito turned to stare at him. Kai gave the baby a huge grin and Hito giggled, reaching out for the shiny teeth that had caught his attention.
Kid's just like his mom. God's always distracted by shiny stuff.
Anko pulled a senbon from her weapons pouch and waved it in front of Hito's face. Hito's eyes latched onto it immediately.
So what are you doing here, Gai-san?
I was only just on my way home from an extensive taijutsu practice with my youthful genin team when I saw you and Hito-chan having a glorious moment of rest, and I just had to come over and youthfully greet you on this beautiful day. Also, I am curiously wondering where Tatsumaki-chan and Kakashi-san are, as they usually have Hito-chan with them when it is after 5 o'clock.
Anko kept one eye on the boy she spoke with Kai.
Tatsumaki-chan said something about a date, and Kakashi was trying to get her to let Hito-chan come with them. But Tatsumaki insisted that Hito didn't have to go with them every single time.
Oh? Kai blinked. How long has my eternal rival been dating Tatsumaki-chan?
Hito grabbed the dancing senbon from Anko's hands and plopped himself down on the counter of the dango store, happily playing with it. Anko was mildly concerned until she remembered that Hito was Tatsumaki and Kakashi's son. She was sure that both of his parents had taught him not to play with sharp objects. Obviously, he was keeping his hands away from the ends of the senbon. She cooed at the pretty, weapons-entranced baby before turning back to Kai.
I don't know, but you know that Hito is Kakashi's, right?
Kai blinked at the Tokubetsu Jonin for a moment before he leaned in and spoke in the quietest voice she'd ever heard from the man.
You have realized that Tatsumaki-chan was only just 14 when she became pregnant, correct?
Oh, pshaw!
Anko waved her hand at the green beast of Konoha.
Obviously, I know that. I was the one that figured out how she got pregnant. I mean, that Kakashi's in love with Tatsumaki-chan and he wants to adopt Hito when they get married.
There was almost an audible snap when Kai straightened in a startled movement.
They are going to be gloriously wed!
Anko nodded, checking on Hito, only to see that he was perfectly fine.
Well, the baby was fine. The senbon had managed to find its way to the back wall of the dango hut, pinning one of the cook's large white hats to the wall. Hito was clapping and pointing enthusiastically, and Anko was sure that even if Kakashi wasn't the biological father, Hito still took after him. Who else but Kakashi's kid would have such aim, so young after all?
I don't know if Kakashi's asked her yet, but he will. He's head over heels.
Hey, whoa there, darling. A fellow Tokubetsu Jonin stopped walking past them and hurried back.
Did you just say that Hatake Kakashi is in love?
Anko gave Hito another senbon, this time watching him to see how he threw it.
Yeah, Genma, I said Kakashi is in love.
Genma leaned on the counter, looking at her and Kai intently.
With who?
He sounded vaguely incredulous, and Anko laughed when Hito threw his second senbon and hit the hat that was pinned to the wall again. The toddler turned to Anko and held out his hand.
Another one, please, Anko-chan.
Genma looked to the toddler in surprise and then did a double take. Hito reached for the senbon that was in his mouth.
Shiny!
Whoa there, little guy. Genma leaned his head back, rolling the senbon to the other side of his mouth, out of reach, and Hito crossed his arms, pouting. So, Anko-san, whose kid?
Anko laughed a little evilly.
This is Yamamoto Hirohito.
Genma gave her a blank look.
Tatsumaki's kid, the girl that Kakashi is in love with.
Genma looked from the toddler to the wall with the two senbon in it to the toddler again.
Kakashi-san's aim?
His or Tatsumaki-chan's.
Anko shrugged.
Not that she was very good to start with, but Tatsumaki-chan is a quick study, and I have yet to see Kakashi not learn something on the first try.
Wait, Genma settled in a free seat. Hirohito-chan is Kakashi's kid, too.
Anko smirked.
Well, she looked at Guy. We are going to get married once Kakashi gets up the courage to ask her. I mean, she loves him too, you know? I don't think he's realized that he loves her back, though.
So, Genma blinked, trying to reconcile this news. Kakashi's son is in love. He has a son. He's going to ask the mother of his child to marry him once he gets his head out of that porn book.
Yes, yes, and yes, Uncle purred.
She would relish the rumor mill having something to talk about in regards to Kakashi. It would probably be the first time that anyone would have the gumption to gossip about the genius, but with rumors like she was putting out, no one would be able to resist.